Hey, what's up guys? This is Vincent, and in this Lightroom Classic tutorial, I'm going to show you how to sort and filter your photos while in the library module. So in front of me, we have the photos that we imported earlier in the lessons, and we're looking at the grid view. And right here, we have the toolbar, and here we have the filter bar. And if you don't see the filter bar, you can toggle this on and off right here. And you can also press a backslash to show or hide the filter bar. And for the toolbar, it's T to show or hide it. And you guys may have figured this out already, but you can also hide like some of the panels. If you just click on these arrows on the side, right here at the top and bottom. The shortcuts for them are the tab button to hide the side panels, and to hide all the panels is just shift plus tab. So shift plus tab hides all the panels and tab hides the side panels. And I showed you earlier the lights out option when you're looking at a photo or grid view in this option, but if you press F, it'll just go to full screen, but usually you'll want to press F or go to full screen while you're looking at the develop module and see how your edits look like. But anyways, let's get to sorting and filtering these photos. So the easiest way to sort is right here. You can sort by capture time, rating, label, color. I don't have any labels or tags associated right now, but anyways, capture time is a default. You can reverse it if you want. I'll just click on this one image here, give it a red, give this one a blue, and then let's see what happens when we put a label color on it. So it's sorted by label color first and then all the other images without a label color, and then we can reverse it if we want. Now we can also change the size of the thumbnails, and here are some more options to view the images by rotating and navigating, as well as clicking on a slideshow if you want, but really you don't need these. What Lightroom produces or shows on the filter or in the toolbar default options is sufficient. Anyways, you can see if I click on here, once again, the filter bar is on and off, and the filters are right here as well, at the bottom as well as at the top. So starting with the most simple filter, this is the kind or the data type. This one right here shows the original photos. This one shows virtual copies. Virtual copies we haven't discussed yet, but it's something we usually use in Lightroom when we're editing or making prints. Pretty much it just makes a duplicate of the image, but doesn't actually copy the file. It just copies a pointer to it, so it doesn't take up any more space. So you can create virtual copies by right here, and it'll just make another image of this, but it points to the original file source. So virtual copies is good when you want to apply different type of edits to the same image. We'll discuss virtual copies later on. It's more important in the print module. Anyways, and the next icon here to filter is the videos. I don't recommend using or importing videos into Lightroom. There's better tools for it, but if you want, you can do that. And then right now we're in the attribute section. So the attribute, you'll be able to filter by flag. If an image is edited, these are some of the images that were edited before during my import. And these images are unedited. So these are all the unedited images. And then you can click on, you can select or filter photos on star ratings as well, or higher than equal to sign right here. None of my images have a star rating on it right now. So let me just click on this. Let me apply star rating of this, star rating of 5, put a flag of pick here, flag of rejected here. So now we can start playing around with this a little bit more. So you can do combinations, as you can see. So there's no image that has been picked that also has a star rating of 4. Okay. And you can also find or filter images by text. You can put in something here and it'll search all the fields. Usually, like if you put keywords or metadata, here's a few of the fields you can search for: captions, keyword, metadata, and then there's like the technical EXIF data and the file data of the image. It gets really technical. It's not something I'm going to discuss in this video, but then you can also go to metadata. Metadata is pretty good because it shows information about your camera. All these sample images have been shot with my Canon EOS 60, and I believe it was a Tamron 24 to 70 millimeter lens right here. So you can sort through the images that way, as well as what focal length you took them with. And there's also the flash state available. And let me see, what else do we have? Everything covered here. It looks good. And then we can click on none. Another option is this lock button. So let's say I want to select all the images that are blue and red, and it's locked right now. And what locked is supposed to do is it's supposed to keep the same attribute if I go to another folder or the filter. So you see it's locked right now. If I go to this HDR folder, it still shows this attribute as selected and it's still locked. But if I go back here, unlock it, go to HDR, now it shows these photos as well, and it changed to none, as you can see. And that pretty much wraps up the sorting and filtering in Lightroom Classic. So if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and follow me on Instagram.